Brothers and sisters, Allah Azza wa Jal has created this universe with all that it contains. He is the creator and the one in charge and in control. Allah says in the Quran, Inna rabbakumu Allahu alladhi khalaqa as-samawati wal-ardha fi sittati ayyam thumma istawa 'ala al-'arsh yughshi al-layla an-nahara yatlubuhu hatitha wash-shamsa wal-qamara wan-nujuma musakhkharatin bi-amrihi ala lahu al-khalqu wal-amru tabarakallahu rabbul 'alamin. Indeed, your Lord is Allah, who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, then established himself above the throne. يغشي الليل النهار يطلبه حثيثا. He draws the night as a veil over the day, each, the day and the night, each seeking the other in rapid succession. وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ وَالنُّجُومَ مُسَخَّرَاتٍ بِأَمْرِهِ. And he created the sun, the moon, and the stars subservient to his command. أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ. Indeed, unquestionably, to him belongs the creation, and his is the command. Blessed is Allah, the Lord of the worlds. SubhanAllah. And Allah Azza wa Jal decreed that his creation go according to what is called a sunan al-kawniyya, cosmic measures, causes, and ways. And Allah Azza wa Jal made these sunan a system that governs this universe with all that it contains. And these sunan act and run and occur by the command of Allah Azza wa Jal. He is the only one who is in control of the sunan. So none, no one and nothing can escape it, can go against it, can oppose it, can prevent it and stop it, or overtake it. Because they all act by the command of Allah. إنما أمرنا لشيء إذا أردناه أن نقول له كن فيكون. Our command for something when we intend it is to say كن, be, and it is. One of the great sunnah Allah Azza wa Jal placed is the conflict between truth and falsehood. You see, Allah Azza wa Jal created people and he made them into groups or parties. One group are those who accept the truth, adhere to the truth, act upon the truth, convey the truth, defend the truth, and sacrifice for the sake of the truth. And the other group are those who oppose it and act against it and want to finish it and vanish it. And Allah Azza wa Jalla blesses whomever He wills to be amongst the group of the truth and its followers. And as for those or the followers of falsehood, then they will not harm Allah Azza wa Jalla and His religion in any. And they eventually vanish and are defeated, even if it takes time. And Allah Azza wa Jalla decreed that this sunnah, the conflict between truth and falsehood, is something that's perpetual, that will not end until the day of judgment. But what is the wisdom behind having such a sunnah, such a way, such a measure? There are many wisdoms and benefits behind this. Number one, distinguishing the followers of the truth, sincere followers of the truth, and the others. As Allah Azza wa Jalla said, لِيَمِيزَ اللَّهُ الْخَبِيثَ مِنَ الطَّيِّبِ. That is so that Allah Azza wa Jalla may distinguish the wicked from the good. See, in the time of conflict, some of those who are with the group of the truth retreat, change heart. So it's a test that distinguishes between the people's true reality that's hidden and that only Allah Azza wa Jalla knows. Secondly, is to prevent corruption and mischief from spreading. As Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَلَوْلَا دَفْعُ اللَّهِ النَّاسَ بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضٍ لَفَسَدَتِ الْأَرْضِ. If Allah had not repelled some people by others, then the earth would have been corrupted. Another benefit for the continuation of this conflict is that Allah Azza wa Jalla alternates defeat and loss, alternates victory and loss between the followers of the truth and the followers of falsehood. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. And these are the days, victory and loss. We alternate them between the people of the truth and the people of falsehood. See, if Allah Azza wa Jalla was to decree that the followers of falsehood, for example, were to become victorious all the time, then corruption would spread, and then the people, the inhabitants of earth, would be deserving of the wrath and punishment of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and that's the end of it. And had Allah decreed that the followers of the truth would be victorious all the time, then these people would be deserving to move to the hereafter, to their eternal abode. But Allah Azza wa Jalla decreed that this continues and alternates until the call is made. وَامْتَازُ الْيَوْمَ أَيُّهَا الْمُجْرِمُونَ. Stand apart, O you criminals! Be distinct, be distinguished from the believers. And on that day, Allah Azza wa Jalla will hold every person for account individually, alone, as in the hadith of Hadith ibn Hatim, which is reported by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ما منكم من أحد إلا سيكلمه الله ليس بينه وبينه ترجمان. Each one of you, Allah Azza wa Jalla will speak to him directly without an interpreter. He will look to the right and he will see nothing but his deeds. And he will look to his left and see nothing but his deeds. And then he We ask Allah to protect us from the fire of hell and make us firm and steadfast on the truth. Allahumma. Another one of the sunan of Allah Azza wa Jal that reflects ultimate justice is the sunnah of establishing evidence against people. So no one would have an excuse with Allah. لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَى اللَّهِ حُجَّةٌ. So that people will not have any excuse with Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal decreed that this is done by Him subhanahu wa ta'ala sending prophets and messengers, conveying that truth to people. And all the messengers fulfilled the task perfectly. And these messengers ended with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who fulfilled this task and his mission perfectly and completely. And then, after the departure of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Azza wa Jal made this the responsibility of these scholars, whom Allah Azza wa Jal made inheritors of the Prophet. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ الْعُلَمَاءَ هُمْ وَرَثَةُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَإِنَّ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ لَمْ يُورِثُوا دِرْهَمًا وَلَا دِينَارًا وَإِنَّمَا وَرَثُوا عِلْمًا. These scholars are the inheritors of prophets, and prophets did not leave behind gold or silver to be inherited, but rather left behind knowledge, the knowledge of the truth, the knowledge that clarifies the truth to people. And the messengers and their followers who conveyed their message after them sacrificed everything for the sake of conveying this message and clarifying it to people. They sacrificed their time, their wealth, and even their lives for the sake of conveying the truth. They remained firm and steadfast until the last minute. And it's not always the case that people appreciate these reformers, these scholars who convey the truth. Many a times, these pious scholars and reformers were opposed by people, by their own people, to the extent that they became oppressed within their communities and people. But with steadfastness and firmness and patience, Allah Azza wa Jalla decrees for their call to be fulfilled and completed, and for the mission to be accomplished. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَنُرِيدُ أَن نَكُونَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنَجْعَلَهُمْ. And we intend to confer favor upon those who were oppressed in the land and make them leaders. Leadership. Leadership of piety. The pride of piety and none else. And nothing else. But this leadership to be obtained, to be blessed with, has conditions to be met and fulfilled. as Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. And we made amongst them leaders guided by our command. How is that achieved? How do I become a leader who guides people? And this is the leadership we're talking about. When they were patient and were certain of our signs. Persevering patiently, remaining firm and steadfast on the faith, on the path, on the religion of Allah Azza wa Jalla, coupled with certainty in Allah, trust in Allah, and reliance in Allah, results in this leadership promised by Allah Azza wa Jalla. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to grant us firmness and certitude until we meet Him. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. Brothers, come forward. There are many brothers outside and there are brothers standing at the door, so please make room for your brothers. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المجتبى وعلى آله وصحبه ولمن سيره اقتفى وبعد. An example was that of the companions of the Prophet of Allah and Rasulullah. The scream of anger of the women. children was heard from outside the valley as loud as it was. Can you imagine that, brothers and sisters? We're sitting in air conditioning, carpet underneath us, driving a car, going, water is as accessible as opening the faucet or putting the glass in the cooler. Everything is readily available for us. And these people, for the sake of making this religion reach Indian youth, went through all of this. Allah. But they didn't change. They did not retreat. They did not weaken. They did not give in. And we remained firm and steadfast and thus deserved leadership. Uqba said, فَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ غَيْرُهُ, I swear by Allah, with whom there is no other deity. لَقَدْ رَأَيْتُنَا نَحْنُ النَّفَرُ, I have seen us, the group of men, each one of us is a governor over an area after the fire. They became deserving because they fulfilled the condition of steadfastness and trust in Allah. You see, firmness and trust in Allah being granted to me and you alone is a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jalla, with which one belittles any harm that befalls him and any affliction that strikes him for the sake of the religion of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So what do we learn? And not all the time people see the result of their da'wah, the result of their sacrifice. And one very obvious example is that of the young boy in the story of the trench, the people of that are mentioned in Surah Al-Buruj. This narration is in the book of Imam Muslim and narrated by Suhaim. And to summarize this story, this boy sacrificed his life for the sake of calling people to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And he died with the arrow of the king, who failed multiple of times to kill him, but he guided him to say, in the name of Allah, the Lord of the young boy, and shoot. And he said, this is the only way you can kill me. And he said that, and we killed him. He died and did not enjoy the fruit of his mission being accomplished and fulfilled. Everybody in that gathering believed in Allah. So we need to remain firm. We need to put our trust in Allah. We need to work for the sake of Allah and not for the sake of seeing results. I've been calling people and nothing has changed. That's not your responsibility. Your responsibility is to do, and the result is with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our responsibility as individuals is to reform ourselves and those under our guardianship, those whom Allah Azza wa Jalla will ask us about. And if we do that, every one of us and a community, the community at large, would be reformed. And then the ummah would be reformed. And Allah's word will be supreme, even if the polytheists dislike it. Wallahu ghalibun ala amrihi, walau kariha al-kafirun, walau kariha al-mushrikun. وكتابه وسنة نبيه وعبادة الموحدين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم ثبت أقدامنا وثبت قلوبنا على